Hi everyone, it's Leanne. I'm going to just finish off some of the pockets in this journal. And I'm just going to do some very ordinary plain straight ones with a little bit of fanciness. Oops, very dropsy today with my hands. I don't know what's wrong with me. Cold probably. Right, we'll just cut that off. Okay. There we go. Okay, that one's sitting okay. Just take that out so we can measure it a bit better. Let me see. What am I up to? I'm going to have to cut that off a little bit straighter. Like that. Let me see if that works. Yes, that's fine. Okay, now we want to make a fancy top, and one way of doing that is to use the Fiskars paper edges. Now these are paper edges, scissors, or you do, I've got a whole bunch of them, they came like that. Let me just get this level first and cut it off. And we're going to fancy the top up like this. Now the scissors get a little bit, sometimes a little bit tangled, hard to cut. I don't know why, they just are, probably because of the paper. But there you go, you see how I've done the top fancy? Now, what we're going to do is put that onto the other piece like that and give it a bit of a border like that, make it a little bit fancier. There we go. I am going to use some double-sided tape. About there. There. And then I am going to cut the rest off so it's not too big. Let me just see if I can get that straight. There we go. Maybe we can cut some more off. So that's still a little bit too much paper. Okay, that'll do. Come on. Okay, so we've got that. Let's take off our double-sided tape. There we go. Let's put it on our base paper evenly. Like that. Let's also edge it up. Give it a bit of an old feel. Okay. Now, there it is there. We've edged it up. We've given it a base and a thrill. And we're going to put it in like that. Now, I'll need some more double-sided tape for that, so let's do that. So I'll put the double-sided tape right on the edge line to secure it, and then just go around the whole entire edge, except the top, of course, with some double-sided tape. It's very simple to do. Like that. Okay, now the trick is to take the back off, and we're going to do that. It's not coming off, so let's go to the other end. Let's try another one and come back to it. There we go. Okay, now let's just put this on our page pretty evenly. Like that. There we go. So there's our pocket we've just created. And we can put some of that ephemera in there now. Let me just get them for you. We have a picture frame there we can use. We've got Nellie, but I think about putting her in the page. Now this one here is very pretty. I think I will put her in with her beautiful lace top. Let's just see how far she goes down. Right, you can pull her back up so her tab is showing at the top, which I like. And let's move over to our next page. Got our theatre ticket there. Now, this is all we've got left. Now, we could put the photo frame in there, like that. Got one on there, got one there. Right, I'm thinking about going to the next signature and putting some more in there, because this has got plenty. So let's go over to the next signature. Right, it's got plenty of ephemera there, but we could do with some more here, like that. Let's see what we can do for her. Right there. Okay. Well, we can put her in there. Just like that. Right, got that. Let's give it a fancy head. We'll cut some off. Maybe about to there. So we can cut that off fancy. Maybe. Let me see. About there. Okay, let's get our fancy scissors back out. Give it a pretty top. Go this way. Right. There we go. Now let's just see if our Yes, it fits perfectly well. All we have to do is put on our thrill, and I think I'll make this thrill a little smaller so it just peeks over the top. That would be nice. Like that. Okay, need some double-sided tape. Like that. Let's take it off the back. And we want to put it on this, just so it's showing. There we go. That's what it looks like. Now let's edge it up. Bit of work involved in a journal, isn't there? It's all those beautiful little finishing touches that make it so sweet, and it's a real workout. Right, that's pretty good. So we're going to double-sided tape once again around the edge lines. Right, there we go. Now let's just take off everything. Going to place it in our diary. Like that. Okay. Sorry about that. And that's what it looks like. And let's put our other. Let me just read it. Jackson Oliver. It must be advertisement of the dress. I think that's what these are. Nellie's the picture thing. That's Nellie there. And this is her diary. So let's leave her there with the tab up top once again. And there she goes. Now we've got one more. Now, I'll be back in a second because I want to grab something. Actually, I don't have to. I'm going to use this lace. Yeah, I think I will. This lace paper. All I'm going to do is give it a tab. So what I'm going to do is fold it in halves. Just take a piece. Make sure it's even. That's not even. Let's just try and work with it. Right. Let's just cut it up so it's even. Just like that. Now I am going to give it a little. Now I had to buy another one. Punch hole. Or a hole punch, a single hole punch. I had to buy another one. So the other one became, it still works, sort of, and I do use it if I had to, but I had to get another one. So here it is here. Oh, packaging these days. It's not what it used to be. All right, let me just see if it works. Feels pretty secure to me. So all we're going to do is we're going to cut half a circle out of the top. Just like that. See how we've done that? And all I'm going to do is staple that on to my pretty little advertisement there and give it a tab like that. Stapler didn't work, typical. It's not too bad. It's not great either. I'm going to pull that out. Don't like it. Just use my small scissors to pull it out. Like that. I did. Let's glue that on. Okay, let's use a glue stick. Boy, there's not much glue left on this. I pulled all my glue sticks out so I could finish them off. If you know what I mean. Use them all up. So let's just give it there some. I should have edged it, but I will edge it. There it is there, a little bit fancy. Let's edge it, just to keep it in with everything else. There we go. Looks pretty good to me. Right, now, where was our pocket? Let me just see where I'm up to. Did we put a pocket in or not? Gosh, I can't remember what we're doing. Let me just go through it again. Right, we did do our pocket and we put that one in. This is another piece of ephemera that we have to put somewhere. But you know what? We don't need a pocket for it. How about we just put it in there with a clip. Let's just give it a yellow one. Like that. Leave the little tab up. Right, that's it. It's got a few tabs in that one. And the other one we've got a few as well. Right, so they look and feel pretty good. Now Nellie, I am going to glue her in. I'm going to put her in the front page. You could put her on the front, but I've got something else planned for that. So let's just use up all our glue, whatever we've got left. Well, that's finished. Actually, hang on a sec. Maybe the winder's no good. Let me just see if I can wind it up. No, that's not going to work. Oh, yeah, it did work. Whoa, I do have a bit more left on that. A lot more. Go. That's the front. Let's put her in so we can straighten her up. There she is. There we go. Drop me glue. Right, and there we go. there's Nellie. She's sitting in there. There she is. It's pretty. Okay, last time I said I was going to bind my book in, but I just used this video to finish off the ephemera, make some pockets, that sort of thing. So I am going to do this off camera, and then I'm going to come back with it. So until I see you next time, bye for now. Take care, particularly on the roads, and have a happy day.